And developing tonight, an apparent murder-suicide and haunting final Facebook posts.
Kevin Copper, the prime suspect in this case, changing his public profile picture, showing him posing with a shotgun only hours before the deadly incident occurred on Loring Avenue. And less than 24 hours before her death, the victim, Danielle Morse, posting these fateful words for the world to see, "I need to get out of this house." Now, as friends and family grieve, experts are sharing insight on the social media signs we should not ignore.
7 Eyewitness News reporter Jeff Slauson working this story tonight live from the town of Hamburg. Jeff?
Jeff and Hannah, as Hamburg police continue to investigate this morning's murder, we're learning more about the young woman who died from her friends that knew her best.
But she was just the kindest soul. I've never met anybody like her in my life, and I don't think I will ever meet anybody like her ever again.
On Tuesday night, Raven dropped 25-year-old Danielle Morse off at this house in Hamburg. It would be the last time she would see her alive.
I was supposed to pick her up this morning, and she told me, if I don't answer the phone, come to my house and wake me up.
But when she arrived, she was met with police cars and caution tape.
I'm shocked by it. From him and being around him, it's not what I would have expected.
Police believe that Morse's boyfriend, 31-year-old Kevin Copper, shot Morse before turning the gun on himself, killing them both and leaving Morse's friends in total shock.
It makes you really think about things in life and, you know, how short life really is.
According to Danielle Morse's friends, Morse had broken up with her boyfriend a few days before her death, with Copper planning to move out the night of the incident. All of her friends thought everything was fine, but on Facebook, Copper had changed his profile picture to a photo of himself holding a shotgun just hours before the shooting. Morse posted this status, saying, quote, "I need to get out of this house," the day before.
And they can go lethal in the snap of a finger.
According to Mary Murphy at the Family Justice Center, social media posts like these can be signs of domestic violence and show the need for help, whether it comes from friends or the abused individual.
This is about power and control. Violence, the threat of violence, those are tools in the toolbox of the abuser.
It's what could have ultimately led to the death of Morse. And her friends remember the best about her, something they wish they didn't have to do.
I wish she was the one standing here doing the interview with you. You can ask her what kind of a person she actually was.
According to Morse's Facebook page, she was a mother of three, and according to the report from Hamburg police, those children were not in the home at the time of the incident. As of right now, the case is still open as they wait for the autopsies to get back, but everything is pointing to the fact that it was a murder-suicide. Live in Hamburg tonight, Jeff Slauson, 7 Eyewitness News.
Tough story. Thank you, Jeff. If you or someone you know is in a violent relationship, help is out there. You can call the National Domestic Violence Hotline 24 hours a day. The number is right there on your screen. This information, we have it also posted on our website, WKBW.com.